Welcome back. On the spot. It's been a minute.
Sure has. We're back.
A lot's happened, but we're here.
Yeah, you guys are at school.
Yeah.
School's going good.
Yeah, having a lot of fun.
Yeah, man. That's awesome. I started a new job.
That's awesome.
Still slinging pizzas, but, you know, different place, you know?
Different place, yeah.
Different place, man.
In the meantime, we won a little award
for
our work here. Thank the academy, all the people who out there supporting us
fully.
All the donors, Bedford TV donors, partners, everyone who comes in here and volunteers.
Yeah.
Lets us do what we like to do, make this show, makes it all possible.
Yeah, this has been awesome.
Yeah.
This has been awesome. Every episode has been awesome. Just to be able to do this is just great, you know? I'm so thankful for it, you know?
And this studio here, anyone can use it. Anyone from Bedford?
Yeah, man, you got an idea? Do it.
That's how we started. We wanted to make some music, and then we had an idea, hey, what if we do like a talk show? What if we do it all improvised? And then here we are.
Yeah, man.
What, 8 episodes later?
I know.
Something like that?
I think 7, but wait. Is it 6, 7? Who knows anymore? Who knows?
It's on the spot.
That's right. On the spot. Yeah, we got Eric here.
What's up?
Yeah, man.
Our
it's been a while.
Pianist of the week.
Yeah.
Pianist of the year.
Yeah, seriously, man.
Of the decade, maybe.
Maybe. Probably. We've only been in the show for a year. But, I mean, 9 more years?
It feels like a decade.
Sometimes it does, yeah. Yeah.
So, I hear you've been drinking bottled water.
Yeah, I have.
Ain't that a ding-donging change?
At school, there's a lot of different food places, food vendors on campus, and basically they all give out bottled water. Tap water? It's good stuff, but...
Yeah. You know. I mean... Yeah, so more bottled water, huh?
Yeah.
I mean, any specific kind? I mean, what are you doing? Crystal Geyser?
Poland? It's the Aquafina.
Aquafina?
Okay. I think that's because that's the Pepsi brand, right?
Ooh.
Our school is like the Pepsi school.
Pepsi water?
Which I have my opinions about, but...
Yeah.
Coca-Cola is better, but I can deal with Pepsi.
Yeah, Coca-Cola is better.
But this is the take, okay?
Yeah.
Bottled water is cool and all, right? The water?
Yeah, it's super cool.
Water's whatever. The bottle.
Uh-huh.
That's the thing. I'll get these bottles from these food vendors when I get my lunch or whatever.
Yeah.
I'll drink all the water and go fill it up with tap water. It's a nice, convenient little bottle.
Why?
Come on.
And I don't even, like, people say, oh, that's gross, you're reusing the bottle. I'll use it for a day, not even.
Reuse a bottle. I mean, that ain't nothing. But if you're just filling it with evil water, you know, I mean, what are we going to do here? Yeah, I mean,
this evil water, now in a convenient plastic, light plastic bottle, fits in the side of your backpack. Dude. I have a massive, like, huge, big metal one. That's way too big.
You got one of those canteens?
Yeah, it's like, it's too
everyone
much.
Has those things, you know?
And sometimes it's too much.
I refuse.
I'm going to class. I can't be lugging around like...
Oh, I know. You're like you're on the Oregon Trail.
Exactly. I'm not going on an adventure. I'm going to class.
Somehow. I mean, you could really nail someone in the head with one of those things. Like, ding!
You drop those things on like a tile floor.
Oh, my God.
Dude, they vibrate.
Bro,
it's so good.
Everyone's like...
Yeah.
You know?
And... But hey, plastic bottle. You drop that. It'll bounce a little.
Ain't nobody looking on that one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially if it's filled with tap water.
What's your favorite plastic bottle?
You know, I think the Aquafina. That's the only exposure I have.
So yeah, you haven't really went out there and explored.
I think normally when I get some, it would be like Poland Springs.
Uh-huh.
That's a solid one.
Solid bottle? Not my favorite, though.
Oh.
Interesting.
The cap's kind of weak.
Yeah,
I get
true.
What you mean.
Oh, I am kind of fidgety with
some
caps.
Of them got the tougher caps.
Yeah, they're weird when you twist them.
Yeah. Like Dasani.
Oh, a bunch of people hate Dasani. Just throw out Dasani.
The cap
just,
on that just thing is like heavy duty.
It's a nice bottle, but that's the worst kind of water. Yes,
people don't like it.
Yeah.
How do you feel about the interesting water bottle designs, like the glass ones at Wegmans?
Oh,
and like
yeah, man.
The Life water with the art.
Oh, those are like Paraguay, Penguin, what is it? Paraguini. what is that called? The green or the blue?
Oh, no. The sparkling water?
No, it's Paraguay. Paraguay.
Something.
Some like the glass?
It's like fancy, yeah.
It's glass.
The blue bottles?
I think this is green.
Oh.
Water tastes worse out of the glass.
Out of the glass? Do you think so?
I don't like
even the glass. Like chilled and everything?
Yeah.
That's true.
Out of the glass bottle, I can't get behind it.
It's not my favorite.
I mean, you're a bottle drinker.
Of what?
Water. Wait, are you a water fountain guy?
Not really. I'm a water bottle drinker.
All right,
I'm
cool. Good enough. We're all on the same page here. This is beautiful.
Yeah, I use my big...
I'm on the right side.
My big refillable thermo flask.
Oh, you got one of the canteens.
Hey, it's convenient.
I mean, it's convenient like water, carrying around a missile.
I don't like refilling it every
time.
That's
true. It's nice to have it.
Put that on your back. People think you're scuba diving.
Yeah, it's 24 whole ounces. That's like...
Jeez, 24 dude.
24 minutes oxygen. Good, dude.
Dude, you gotta pee all over the place.
It's nice to like have it in like one spot.
Yeah.
So you get like your nice amount of water. But carrying that, it's too much.
You know, I got a confession to make. You like eggnog?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Everyone I've been asking, they don't like it.
Really?
Dude, I have an eggnog addiction. Like, it's been 2 weeks and I have drank almost a gallon and a half of eggnog.
Gee, that's a lot.
This is like drinking heavy cream sometimes.
I know, dude. I wake it up, my stomach.
Gotta be careful.
It's nuts, dude. You get it at Chippin Farm.
Oh, man.
It's a Chippin Farm. You go to Chippin Farm, but they have a Shaw Farm eggnog. Mm. And I'll tell you what, man. This almost changed my life. I had this sip.
Dude, there's a ice cream chain called Mitchell's in Cleveland.
Oh, Mitchell's?
They make eggnog ice cream.
Oh, dude, I would.
It's so
mess up a ice cream.
It's so good.
Eggnog ice cream. That's probably year round too, isn't it?
It is not. Unfortunately, they got seasonal flavor.
The real stuff.
Yeah, you gotta go when the time's right.
I guess that's good, man. Because you'll overdose on eggnog.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, you don't want to do that.
I feel like that's like part of the charm. I feel like you drink it all year round. Uh-huh. You'd be sick of it.
So I'm already kind of getting a little like.
Yeah.
You know. It's weird because I got a lactose thing, but I can drink that stuff till the cows come home, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's nutty.
Yeah.
I'm crazy with the eggnog. Zach, you like eggnog?
No, not really.
All right, we got to know. Yeah. I knew it was coming. So you did like it and you just drank too much and now you just will never have it.
Yeah.
Did you put alcohol in it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll do it. Put that Henny in there?
Yeah, I don't know what they put in there.
Drop that Henny? Do you guys put alcohol in it?
Hey,
I abstain. You would never do that because you are not of age.
Yeah.
That is, of course you wouldn't do that.
Hey,
good question.
What the heck am I doing? I forgot that, yeah. Yeah, man, eggnog.
It's fun, a little, put the nutmeg on top.
Oh, you know what? I'm going to do that when I get home.
You've never done that? It's like classic.
Dude, you like grate a little bit of nutmeg on there.
Oh, I'm going to do that.
So good.
I'm going to go nutty for the nutmeg.
Yeah.
Eggnog latte.
Ooh. Oh, see, now we're going to throw up.
Take a shot of espresso, put some eggnog in there.
Oh, I did that.
It's so good. Yes.
Two shots of the Lavazza, put that in the eggnog. You're done, dude. You're done. Yeah, you're all good for the day.
Yeah, corner of the day.
Dude.
Bedtime.
Yeah, I look like a real fatty man because I will eat my dinner and then I'll have this big ass, big glass of eggnog.
Mm-hmm.
And dude, I'll tell you, I'm like, at the end of it.
Yeah.
You know, just uncomfortably watching TV. It's crazy.
I feel like my dessert tolerance has gone up at college.
Me too, man. The older you get, it'll get worse. You better watch out.
Uh-oh.
You better watch out, man, because it'll get worse.
Like.
Better get your steps in when you eat that ice cream.
You ever have that like peppermint bark?
I'll have a few bites, but you know what? I just
not for you.
I mean, just you know, it's too much. I'm not. I like peppermint, but I'm not like crazy about it. You know what I mean? I'll have a candy cane once in a while, but
yeah.
I'm not one of those like peppermint guys.
Mm. I feel like it's like it's like either you love it or you hate it.
Yeah, I mean. I'll do a little bit, but I'm not going nuts on this peppermint.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? It's just crazy, you know? You a big peppermint guy, Zach?
I like peppermint bark and
Yeah.
Nice.
Sick ice cream, yeah.
The peppermint stick ice cream. That's what's
I'll up. Do it a little bit, but I'm not, you know, I'd rather the eggnog.
Sometimes, it's like when they get the little candy cane chunks in the ice cream, it's a little much. It's like a little chewy, and it's not...
Yes, dude.
The flavor's good and all, but like...
I feel like that with fruit in my ice cream. Mm. Like, I don't want a dang strawberry, frozen strawberries in my ice cream.
I mean, it's interesting.
I see where you're coming from.
You get that frost bite, that...
Interesting.
Yeah, it's just too much. I can't deal with it.
A frozen fruit advocate.
You like it?
I eat frozen fruit. It's like straight.
I like make a smoothie with it. Yeah, that's like...
That's good.
Okay, yeah.
You get like a big bag of like fruit, frozen fruit from the...
Fruit!
Get some fruit from... Get that market basket, mixed berry, frozen.
Dude, I was going to Whole Foods every day and getting a smoothie.
Yeah.
It's not good, man. It's like $10.99. The thing, you know, and you know, on top of it, it's horrible for you. You know what I mean?
Full of sugar, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Full. You can't blend your fruit.
I used to go to Whole Foods, like the hot bar, after school.
Oh, dude!
Like music rehearsals. I get lasagna.
I remember
mac and cheese and chicken.
Yeah. Oh, that sounds great.
Dude,
great.
The
it was just $25 a day.
Oh dude, my god!
The almonds. The almonds.
The almonds.
Dude, you got almonds.
Dude, I eat so many nuts. I got nuts in my car right now.
It's like the perfect snack.
Almonds and hazelnuts. Big thing, like this.
That's all you need.
Dude.
Like the most portable, convenient. Doesn't go bad. Well, do they?
Not really.
Not really, dude.
Not really.
Especially if they're seasoned, like with salt or something like that. That's never going to go bad.
You ever mess with honey roasted?
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, that's another one you gotta, like, you gotta chill with, you know?
Dude, my roommate's grandma had, like, an innovation. She sent him honey-roasted peanut butter. So there's honey in the peanut butter.
Get out.
And just we take some pretzel sticks and we dip it in there. Dude, it's so good. It may be one of the best things.
Dude, have you ever heard of Saratoga peanut butter?
What is that?
So it's a company. Uh-huh. They make their own peanut butter.
Uh-huh.
And they have different flavors. So you have, like... chocolate peanut butter, that's one flavor, and it's like maple's another one, and just regular or chunky, or I hate that word, chunky. Do you ever have words that you hate, that you just, someone says it and you're like, ugh, come on? I got like a plethora.
Probably, but can't think of any off the top of my head. If you said it, I'd probably be like,
damp.
Say it again.
You got one?
Damp.
Damp? Oh, I see that.
Like damp.
I see that.
I feel like it's like, it's also about like what it means. Like no one likes being damp, you know?
Yeah.
Right. So I got flap.
Mm. Oh yeah. I don't
flop.
Like
that. I just had the other one. Oh, when like grown men say yummy.
Oh.
Oh my god. What are we doing? I think when anyone says yummy, but if a grown man's like, oh, it's yummy, I'm like, dude. You know?
Yeah.
Yummy? You over there saying yummy? Get out of town with that.
I don't like it when people say delish with no us.
Oh, well, they kind of shorten the...
Yeah, I see.
That. Oh, that's delish. Like, I can't find myself saying that.
No, I agree with that. I agree. That's a little annoying.
Mm.
Do you have any words, Zach, to kind of make you cringe?
Well, like you said, delish is definitely one of them.
Really?
That's cool.
Wow. Any other ones?
None that I can think of off the top of my head.
Yeah.
I know there's some out there.
What about when a grown man says yummy?
Yeah, I agree with that one.
Awful. Awful. Don't ever say yummy. It's just disgusting.
It's like the only scenario that happens, or that it should happen, is you talking to a toddler.
No, I see grown men say it to me. Just people saying yummy to me all the time. This is yummy. Oh, shut up. God. Yeah. I'm trying to. There's got to be another one. I don't know. It'll come up.
So, what kind of music you've been listening to?
Oh, music. Yeah, it's a music show. Right. I forgot.
Sometimes it is.
Music. Well, we talked about Fred again. Mm. Really diving into him. Selectively.
Yeah.
I can't do too much dance, like, stuff, you know what I mean? Let's see, what else? I don't know. Let me take a gander. Yeah, why don't you go while I
What do you got?
I've been in Cleveland.
Mm-hmm. In Cleveland. In the Cleveland music scene.
I've been in the Cleveland music scene.
In Cleveland, guys. They don't do music over there. Except for what we make it.
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like I've been in my hip hop.
That's nice.
My hip hop resurgence lately. Mm-hmm.
Nice. I feel.
A lot of West Side Gun for me.
Nice.
Oh, nice, dude.
That new album.
He works with The Alchemist a lot.
He does, yeah.
I've been listening to a lot of The Alchemist.
One of the biggest changes brought upon me by college.
Yeah.
I do not mind Drake anymore.
Oh, come on.
Hey.
I'm a Drake fan.
Oh, my God, dude. I take the microphone. I'll walk out.
You know who just worked with Drake?
Oscar the Grouch.
On,
that was dumb.
He did the deluxe part of the new album, the new Drake album.
Dude, it's so good.
The Alchemist. It's a little, like, you can tell, it's like, the beats are like Alchemist beats, mm-hmm. and then it's Drake over them.
Oh, that's weird.
Dude, it's so weird. Good.
When I started listening to it, I was like, either this is the greatest thing I've ever heard, or the worst thing I've ever heard. I can't tell.
Dude, first day of work, mm-hmm. they were going like, you know, who do you listen to for music and stuff like that, and the girl was like, yeah, Drake. And I was like, you know?
No Drake.
And they got all offended, mm-hmm. and they stopped talking to me.
Well...
Everyone, they were like, he doesn't like Drake. Meh.
Yeah, speak your truth.
Yeah, speak your
truth. Dude, I was owning it. I was like, yeah, Drake stinks.
I understand it sometimes, mm-hmm. but...
I just can't... I
Stories about my brother, bro.
Yeah?
Great track.
Okay.
There's certain, like, Feel No Ways, like, Views, that whole album. It's just like... It's like, I think it's 2015, 16, 17, somewhere around that. it's like so those years. It's just like...
Mm-hmm.
Maybe one day.
It's okay. It's like very, it's not for everyone.
No, it's not.
It's been a weird mindset to listen to Drake. I feel like I'm never listening to him casually.
Yeah.
I feel like I only listen to him casually.
Really? I feel like I'm only listening to him when like I'm like locked in on my work.
Hmm.
Like having him in the back.
It is weird. You kind of, you choose certain music for certain things that you're doing. Mm. Right? Like when I'm driving, I'll do a lot of soundtracks.
Mm.
You know?
Dude, in my dorm, I got this nice ambient setup.
Oh, yeah?
My coffee table book.
Oh, nice.
Got my speaker on there. It projects orange light.
Woo!
I got the.
Nothing like an orange light.
That Lego McLaren I built with you right next to it.
I just
blast ambient music out of it when I'm in my room, and it's so nice. But then when I'm working, I need Drake. I can't be ambient. Mm. Being ambient means I'm gonna fail. I need to succeed.
Ooh, with Drake. Start from the bottom.
Oh, jeez, come on. You just spout lyrics. I won't convert.
My study music recently has been some like 90s R&B.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, I love that. That's amazing.
So I'm just like, I feel like I talk about it every time I'm on this show. But this resurgence the past like 3 weeks for finals and stuff, I've just been grooving with.
Did you meet a girl?
I did.
That's what did it. I knew it.
Oh my goodness.
I knew it.
Well,
that's something special, man.
But like 90s R&B. A
little Splash of Wonderful.
Yeah.
Mm. Vainglorious.
Splash of Wonderful. But
I'm happy for you, man.
Thank you.
Zach, what have you been listening to, man?
I don't know.
Yeah?
I like Buckethead.
Oh, yeah, Buckethead, dude.
I love Buckethead.
Pretty good.
I listen to these days.
Ah, oh, man. He's the best, dude. He really is. I've never seen his face.
Who has?
He doesn't show it on camera.
Yeah.
He only has, like, a select circle of friends that know him behind the mask.
That's the way it should be, right? I wish I started out like that.
Came on this show.
You know. Just life.
Just life. You should walk around like a Daft Punk helmet the whole time.
I was born with it on. Right?
Yeah. Actually, guys, let me...
the mask on.
So, yeah, a lot of soundtracks. Vanilla Sky soundtrack.
Oh, nice, yeah.
I don't know how to say this. Sugar Ross.
Oh, I know you're talking about.
Yeah. Yeah. Alchemist. Mm-hmm. The soundtrack, the end of the effing world.
Uh-huh.
The soundtrack to that.
Is that...
I haven't watched it, so I don't know what the heck it is. Yeah. Christmas music.
Of course.
You know, Jimmy Smith. Mm-hmm. Woo, he gets down. Woo, a lot of organ stuff.
Nice.
Woo, my friend showed me that. Little Jimmy McGriff. Little Christmas music. Another organ stuff. Beautiful. Yeah, I mean, that's about it, you know. And some Italian music, which I don't know how to pronounce.
Christmas music too. I'm a big fan of the Christmas Motown.
Oh yeah.
Christmas Motown, Christmas jazz, like all sorts of good stuff that you never hear on the radio ever.
Yeah, it's really the way to go.
Yeah.
Tyler the Creator.
Nice.
Duh. Mm-hmm. New Andre 3000 yeah. album.
Mm-hmm. That's it's good.
Now that is some like thinking music.
Yeah, it is.
You know.
Oh, you want some thinking music?
Yeah.
I've been listening to the entire Lil Yachty. No, the most recent album.
The one we...
The psychedelic one.
Black Samba? Whatever.
The Black Samba. Was the first. Yeah.
Black Samba.
Let's start here.
Yeah, let's start here.
Yeah.
I've listened to the entire thing straight in order. Like, just like all the way through on repeat.
I find myself doing that. You know, you pick something and you just kind of... You listen to it all the time and all the time. You know what I mean?
It's so good.
I saw him in concert.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, what? Like recently?
Yeah.
Ooh, how was that?
It was pretty good. He had like, kind of the first half of the show was, he had like a whole band, like a full band out.
Yeah.
And they did like the new album. Mm-hmm. And then he came out after and like did like three or four. It was like super popular, but more like, it's like older stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it was really good.
That's awesome, dude. A good concert will just get you going. This new show, The Curse, it's on Paramount Plus. I liked it. It's really awkward. It's an awkward show. It's with Emma Stone and some guy. I don't know his name. It was all right, but the soundtrack's really great.
Yeah.
So I've been listening to that a lot. Yeah, I mean, that's about it.
Yeah.
You know? But yeah.
We got some good stuff.
Sure do.
We got some fun music and a little taste of the holidays.
And I'm sure you could tell we have Zach here today.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll have the camera over there.
Unbelievable. Beautiful. Unbelievable, the thing that he did. I think it's his best thing, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah. That got me emotional.
It was really good.
That was so good. Great job, man.
So I hope you enjoy.
Yeah.
Dude.
And next time you're going to be in here with us talking.
I will.
Yeah, see, he said it. It's on camera, too, so.
Hey.
That would be delish.
Yeah.
That would be so damn, bro.
Enjoy the show.
Yeah, bro.
Like.
An energy I feel is passing through the pines, through the wintry New England woods. I can feel it deep within my bones, like a good omen. The green and red neon vibe jiving from house to house. As the energy morphs from the pines, emerges into town, it takes the shape of a spiral. Wreaths with red ribbons swing in those merry jingle bell ring lights. Indeed, the frosty wind chills are biting our rosy cold ears, calling us back home. Back into the pervasive glitz and glamour of the celebrated tree. The massive gifts calling to the attention of cheerful children. Oh, just look at the prismatic collage, says Aunt Betty. Could it be the energy? How the elders long to be reborn, to feel the spry wits of long-lost youth on this convivial ho-ho-ho holiday. Silent it is not, inside nor outside, on this most of holy nights. Could it be the energy? Because as the stars pour down all the dazzling glitter, the heavenly stars which show off the magic of the eve, There is upon our mirthful faces an aura alike, one of faith, hope, and bubbling delight. An energy, as it were, that transforms mystic silhouettes into ice sculptures which glisten in the city square. Hot chocolates, sleigh bells, candy canes, what could compare? Perhaps it is the energy, the magic of the eve. The taste, the sounds, the neon-colored sights, it all brings together what once was never there. A seraphic wavelength. Frequencies bending in a matrix for the senses. Simply a harmony waiting to be heard. Can you catch the vibe?
Thank you. Mm-hmm.